Stärke wird. Until help, you still try to achieve your goals. After help or below help, you're thinking, guilt, in this area, you don't care if you damage something. You just feel guilty. You don't improve towards your goals. You try to hide something. You don't achieve your goal. You just hide something. If I damage this, and you ask me who did it, I don't know. So I don't achieve any goal with this. Or I try to be more important. So I am the coach. I am the therapist. So I am so important. Look at me. It doesn't change anything. It doesn't change much. Because if someone comes to me and shows his certificate and says, okay, this certificate is so important, you need to take his session with me. Who cares? If I cannot have a good communication with the person, so I don't care about the certificates. What happens below this point, you try to not achieve your goal by leaving, for example. Ist das beschützen?
Protect.
Protecting, abandoning, and suffering. Let's make an example how it works. Let's say with the relationship. You are interested in each other, and this is not enough. After a while, you need some communication, because just looking at her lips, you cannot read her thoughts. So you need to talk to each other. You see that you fail in talking, you try to have more control. You say, okay, listen to me. Look at me. I'm talking to you. It's more control. You try to use control as a solution to get interest. This fails. So between all the stages you have failed. And you try the next one as a solution. So if the control doesn't work, you ask a friend to help. You find the tools, you find solutions or something to get help. If this does not work, you don't care anymore. It's for you okay if there is a damage happening. The relationship can go anywhere. You don't care much anymore. You try to hide things. You know, the relationship is not going well, then one of them is, you know, trying different things. So the relationship is getting damaged because you hide something. You don't talk about everything easily. So if you come to this area, then you try to make things that are not usually important more important. You say, you know, for me it's very important that you come at 10 o'clock home. You know, if you don't come, our relationship is breaking. I say, you know, this is very important for me to do this and that and blah, blah, blah. So the relationship is not anymore important, but something else. As we try, of course, you can create value or importance for yourself or for someone else by just doing the exercise with appreciation. But if you fail in this, if your partner is not doing the things that are for you important, and they are so important, one of you will leave. If you don't leave physically or officially, you just try to make kind of, how to say, inner leaving. You are just like a robot. You are sitting there, and your partner is sitting there, you're watching TV. You have no real relationship anymore. not relationship anymore. In this area, you don't try to protect anything because it's obvious that you both are working towards the relationship. But if you left already in your mind the relationship, the only thing that you try as a solution is to protect what is left. If you fail to protect, then you abandon. You give up somehow. You say, I cannot do anything. You know, the relationship is already done. I cannot protect. I did everything to protect it, but it's done. But what happens if you fail and giving up? It's sometimes to some people a strange idea, but you can still suffer. You give up on something, you say, okay, this relationship is over, but you cannot get out of this relationship. In Iran, for example, if you are a woman and you are married and you divorce, afterward you have no partner, you have no chance to marry again. And if you have no partner, no one, no government is supporting you. So you prefer to suffer in this not existing relationship than to get out of it.
So we are lost.
Yeah, it's not only lost. Let's say if you a lion is coming to you, so you try to leave and you fail. You try to protect yourself, the lion still is coming. After a while you say, okay, just eat me. But he don't eat you at once. He's eating this part of your feet and you suffer and say, oh, I would, you know, you give up already. You are not running away, you're doing something. You just lay down and you suffer. And he's eating this part, and then some bacteria come to this and say, oh my God, can you eat me please once? And it's over. It's not. So there are still points below this. But let's say this area is something that you look at in a session. So it's nothing that we do in a group. But what you can do is from this part up in a group. This first thing we did already with the appreciation exercise. So you don't need to find the solution for importance. You don't need to learn for a certificate to be appreciated. You don't need to do something to be appreciated. You can just create it out of nothing. You just find someone who is valuable enough for you. You just feel the feeling, and you are the whole space filled up with appreciation, more than you need. Okay? Just be, and that's it. Okay? So how can we go up from this point? If you can feel appreciated, whatever people say or not say or what they do, then you have a chance to get rid of the things that you hide. Okay? Maybe we can sit a bit different so that you have two people close to each other. Marie, a bit nach vorne. Try to say to each other lies. Make sure that they are lies about yourself, about the things that you have or do or are. I prefer the things that you do or are. Just find something about yourself that you are or you do. Make a lie of it, change something about it, so that you try to get more appreciation from the other person. Okay. How do you feel? come to an end. I know it's fun. Okay, okay, stop lying. Please, for a few moments. Okay, even here, you. You will have a chance to lie for all your life. But, no, stop this. Yeah. You know what is fun about lying? It's the, Tom? You know what is the best part about lying? Oh, please, stop lying. So the best part about lying is you become creative. You are telling things that does not exist. This is the lowest level of creating, but still you are creating, and it's fun. The question is, can you get some importance by lying? How does it feel? If your partner was lying to you, could you give him more importance because of the lies?
Kinda.
Yeah. Because you give importance to the creativity or something, but it's not the person itself. So if you get importance because of the lies you tell, the importance goes. Yeah, don't touch it. Even if it's fun, and yeah, and you don't feel very very connected. You don't feel yourself. You feel someone else somehow. Is that attracting the importance? So it's no need to try this. But if you don't hide the things, let's say find something that you don't feel deserves a lot of importance. You have things done that have been wrong. You have damaged something. There are things that you feel guilty about. If you talk about these things to your partner, can you think of something like this? Or you have never been guilty or feel damaging something?
That is a lie.
Sure it's not.
Yeah, yeah.
You know something?
And one important thing, if your partner says something like this to you, just say thank you for being honest. Don't try to do anything else. But saying yeah. No lies. You just listen to what the person says to you, that he's guilty or damaged something, and you say thank you for being honest.
I've cheated on you.
Yeah.
About a million times.
Yeah. Good.
Okay.
Something why you failed and you went down.
Yeah.
Okay? So you need someone that you are sure he will react in the correct way. And this is why I said, as a therapist, you need to be able to love your client. If you are not able, you do like this, something like this, strange things. And the next thing is, we are organizing, we are organizing 2 times 2 days. It's like the next month, at the end of next month, is 2 days for handling assholes, you could say, idiots, egoists, whatever you could say. Yeah. So to feel stable, centered, balanced, even if such people try to do something. So the first part of that will be to recognize these guys, and then the 2 days you need to,
become invincible.
Become invincible. Mm. Yeah. You don't just feel okay. You just feel above this kind of people because they are not as strong as you are.
In English or in German?
In German.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. But the main thing is, the most of these 2 days is coaching each other. So two people like you are doing now become a couple somehow, and you support each other the whole 2 days. And I just describe the exercises and just do it. And I make sure that you are doing them right. That you are doing, one day is here and one day is in the basement. And so, this is really amazing. I we did this with a few friends and it was like, yeah. Maybe
so
we can.
Is it still open for joining or is it already?
No, I did not announce it.
Ah, you did not.
So I just rent a room. So is someone here that knows this and can talk about this a little bit?
Maybe.
Okay. So what would you say? Is it good or not?
It's very interesting. It's very different from everything I did before.
Yeah.
But it helps. It really helps. You need a lot of concentration. Don't drink and go late to bed the day before.
Yeah.
You need a lot of concentration, but it helps a lot.
Yeah. Great. Thank you. So be alert about the next announcements about the things that are coming. So next thing is head. This is easy. Just remember a time that you knew the goals of someone. You supported this person towards his goals and he achieved it easier, better, or faster. How was the feeling?
Amen.
Yeah. Yeah? You liked it, huh?
Satisfying.
Okay. And it's very, very, you feel appreciation for yourself if you see that you helped someone. You don't need appreciation from someone else. You know you helped, that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So, can you remember a moment that someone helped you?
When the eyes start to pop.
Supported your real goals, and you achieved your goals easier, faster, better. Can be simple things like you went to the doctor, or you took a flight, and because of the flight you went faster, or easier, or better to some place. But the goals, if the deeper they are, the more intense is this appreciation for the person. Yeah. Okay. So next thing is control. So we saw already, if you don't take control, it's sometimes also a lack of responsibility and it's a lack of knowledge or knowingness about this subject. So the more you know about your partner, the more you should take responsibility and the more you should take control. If you dance, and it doesn't matter who's leading. You know, let's say as a man, usually I lead, but I follow the music, of course. If I don't follow the music, they do strange movements. If my partner is not controlling her own movements, you know, I try to lead some turns, but if she is not turning, some girls, you know, they don't let themselves lead because they have arms like this, and I try everything and they don't move in any direction.
Yeah.
But if both of you have enough control and about responsibility and about knowledge about you exchange something, it could be emotions, it could be money or talking or whatever, it's always more fulfilling if you listen, you accept what it's sent to you, make the other person know that you accept it, maybe you can do it. So you say something, it should be accepted, because if the person does not accept it, you feel ignored. And then you wait until the person says to you, and then you accept it. Just this exchange alone can make your friends or whatever who you are coaching sane. You don't need to talk about specific things. You can say hello, and he says okay. And then he says hello, and you say okay. If you do it for 1 hour, both of you feel good. The strange thing is, if this breaks, if you talk to me and I don't listen and I ignore you, it feels strange. If I do this the whole life, each time you want to talk, I don't accept it, I break you here. You feel strange, if you say. If most people that start to talk to themselves, it's because they talk and it is never accepted or never came to an achieving point. So they start to answer themselves. If you had a partner and you asked something and she got lost or something, people die and you don't get the answer that you are expecting. So you are waiting for the answer. You get somehow answer hungry. So this can make you suffer. And the last exercise is maybe to get back to the room. Be interested in this part of the room. Try to find out how to be interested. This is something that you create, this is something that you decide, you choose today. Try to be interested in this part of the room. Okay? Try to be interested in this. Good. Just to be interested. You don't need to see. Okay? Be interested in that part of the room. Yeah, it's a new area. Mm-hmm. Do you feel interested?
Can you?
Huh? Oh, you are interested in more things? Okay, this is fine. So you can be interested in your whole life. And this makes the life more interesting. You will get the chances. And I'm sure you will change not only your life, but also the life of a lot of people. Thank you for joining.